Hi, Benedict Casey from The Formery. We thought we'd invite fashion retailers into the conversation about fashion, and today we're at Goodness and we're going to speak to Christine Hales. Good morning.
Hi, Benedict.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Good, thanks. How are you?
Good, 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 good.
Are you okay out there in the wind?
Yeah, but it's beautiful and warm for a change.
Isn't it?
Yeah. Hey, thank you for talking to us.
Thank you for asking me.
Oh, you're welcome. So we wanted to include in this discussion around fashion, fashion designers, people in the industry, people in sustainability, and fashion retailers who are on that cold face of it and interacting with customers on what your view is and where the fashion industry is at the moment and where you'd like to see it.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
That's a big question.
Yeah. So, what's your personal approach to buying? Like, what do you look
for? Me personally, my own wardrobe.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of natural fibres. If it doesn't feel nice, I won't put it on. It might look great, but if it doesn't feel great, I can't wear it.
Yeah.
I guess I'm a bit trend driven because I'm a fashion buyer, so I sort of see things ahead of time, and you know, so I will wear what's on trend for that season, but I've also got to take into consideration height, you know, all of it, the fit.
Yeah.
So it's kind of a complex question, and I think we all dress in costumes as well, so it comes down to how you're feeling at the time or on the day or
I mean, the reason for the fashion industry is really not the only reason, but it's all self-expression, isn't it?
Absolutely. Yeah.
We play this game with my family when we're out and say we're having a coffee somewhere, and we'll have this this game where by what someone's wearing and how they look, we make up stories about them. So this guy's an accountant, he lives in blah blah blah, simply from the perception you get from what they wear.
Yeah, absolutely. It's like that, you know, sitting in an airport, people watching, you know, you can play that game on your own.
Yeah, that's right.
I mean, we all do it, and we all make, you know, that whole first impression, and based on what somebody's wearing, you think that you know exactly who they are, what they do, probably even where they live, you know?
So, yeah, kind of shortcode.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, so in your store, what's your ethos around who you stock?
Okay, so, you know, over time the labels that we stock have changed for varying reasons. Either, you know, they've changed direction or we've changed direction, or, you know, they're going, you know, into other stores or opening their own stores. So at the moment we stock mostly New Zealand brands. We've got a couple of European brands. We've got our own brand, which we are growing, and that's going to be where we put our focus over the next few seasons.
Yeah.
So that's exciting. I don't. I'm going to buy natural fibres where I can. Again, that's, you know, for me as a buyer, and personally, it sort of translates into what I buy for the store as well. I like lots of colour. I don't often wear a lot of colour, but I like to buy it for the store. I try very hard to buy ethical brands. You know, the whole slow fashion movement where we buy for a season and no more. We can't order in. You know, it's made specifically on order,
right,
6 months ahead of time. So there's, yeah. So yeah, so that's how I do it really, and it's often not very scientific. If I like it, I buy it.
Yeah. There's been this stat that's been floating around a bit about 30% of stock that comes into store doesn't go out through sales. Like it.
For us?
Generally, worldwide.
Yeah.
And I don't know, it's what I want to ask you about your experience in it, because 30%, if you're purchasing and 30% of your stock just disappears, isn't sold or is dumped or is...
We never dump. It's true that 30% of stock will go into sale.
Right.
And it goes out at a reduced price. If it doesn't move in that season, and that season's sale,
yeah,
we hold on to it and it comes back out. And that, you know, if when the price is right, it will go. So we certainly don't dump. We've had the odd thing that, for one reason or another, has just been a dud, or you know, it's come in ahead of its time. That happens.
Yeah.
You know, fashion things that people look at and think that's great, but I'm going to wear it on, that scares me.
Yeah.
And so, you know, we just recycle them through our sales, and occasionally we will donate them to places like Dress for Success, or or I let my staff at it. So, you know, they have access to what's there, and and I give it to them, you know, so certainly not dumping anything.
So within the fashion industry, what's consuming you most at the moment?
Well, we've all seen H&M open in the Wellington region over the last few weeks, and you can't miss the billboards. They're everywhere.
And they're enormous.
Enormous.
So
everywhere. And they're advertising the prices on those billboards. And if you look at those prices, you know that somebody's absolutely hurting to make something.
Yeah.
Make a garment.
$7.99 bikinis.
Yeah. So my real issue is mass production and the crazy appetite that those mass-produced, low-cost garments, you know, they just create this appetite for garments that people don't need.
Yeah.
And then I see that there's two layers of waste there. So the mass, they can't possibly sell it all, so they dump what they don't sell.